Yesterday, Vision Group launched the 15th edition of the Bride and Groom Expo in a vibrant event that took place at Sheraton Hotel in Kampala. The event was also graced by different sponsors who will take part in the expo. The editor-in-chief for Vision Group, Barbara Kaija, thanked the people who have been part of the expo for the past 15 years.
Thank you so much for believing in us. Pepsi, Penny Bold Bride, Cafe Gervais, thank you so much. The Looks, Fraglino, Signature Jewelry, Sheraton Uganda, KTB, Uganda Airlines, Marasa Africa, and Diego. Thank you so much for the support. We really appreciate it. Thank you for believing in us. 15 years is crystal. Crystal is hard, it's enduring, it's beautiful, it has shine. And that is what Bride and Groom has come to be. But also that's what most of our partners have come to be, especially those we started with from the word, from day one. Of course, we hope that those who have just joined will stay with us for another 15 years. So when we celebrate 30 years, you'll be as beautiful as we are at Crystal.
At an entrance fee of only 10,000 shillings per person, participants will be treated to a host of activities and experiences from a variety of service providers, events planning experts, and bigger prizes to be won. The Bride and Groom Expo provides a platform for couples to learn and plan memorable wedding ceremonies. Police in Busia are holding four suspects for allegedly vandalizing electricity infrastructure. The suspects have been identified as 52-year-old George Williams Mwanguzi, Wanyama Ivan, 45, Ofiti George, 46, and Masiga Robert, 45. They're accused of stealing electricity transmission wires and tampering with electricity power connections in Dabani sub-county. Othieno Richard, the Busia branch Umeme manager, confirmed that the suspects have never been their staff and added that they have a problem with these vandalizers of the electrical wires and appealed to the community to be vigilant.
We do condemn such behaviors, and some of these vandals, I think they carry out themselves, they pretend to be many workers in the first place, the imposters. They pretend to be many workers, but the fact is they are not many workers.
Kanuna Grace, the deputy RDC Busia, confirmed about the arrest of these vandals and said that the vice has been so rampant in the area. He added that the suspects are being processed to appear before courts of law.
I want to appreciate our team of security that these four people were arrested, and they are with our police here in Busia. And the information that I have, I think their file is now complete. They are taking it to RSA for perusal so that he can guide on the next course of action.
The suspects were arrested in a joint operation made by police, Umeme officers, and community members of Dabani Village in Dabani sub-county. Sironko District has registered a steady rise in teenage mothers, accounting for over 38,000 in number. It is believed that most of the girls in the district got pregnant during COVID lockdown and unfortunately failed to reintegrate in school. Many of these young mothers are poverty-stricken and are in ardent need of support. Ashama Fabi Lumolo, the former contestant of Sironko District and Member of Parliament, expressed a number of challenges faced by the teenage mothers in the district. She highlighted high poverty levels and stigmatization as key challenges. In an event graced by the RDC of Sironko District, Nusura Nabukalu at Mutufu Playground, the Mafabi Asha Foundation donated over 35 tailoring machines to aid in skilling these teenage mothers. Asha Mafabi Lumolo expressed her commitment to continually helping teenage mothers.
Because I realized that there was an overwhelming number of teenage mothers. In Sironko, we have over more than 38,000 teenage mothers, which is quite embarrassing. Last year, we were the first in defilement. This year, we are the third in defilement. There is a question mark. And the only way we can solve this problem is if all of us come together as a united force